وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، الله عز وجل he says وكل إنسان ألزمناه طائره في عنقه ونخرج له يوم القيامة كتابا يلقاه منشورا. Allah تبارك وتعالى he says every soul, every individual ألزمناه طائره في عنقه. Allah says we have imposed his fate on his neck, every individual. وَنُخْرِجُ لَهُ, Allah says, we'll bring out for him. وَنُخْرِجُ لَهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, the day of judgment, كِتَابًا, a book. يَلْقَاهُ مَنْشُورًا, which he will see laid open in front of him. That's the verse, inshallah ta'ala, I want to go through. Allah here, he says, وَكُلَّ إِنسَانٍ مِنْكُمْ, O people, every single person from amongst you. Allah has what? أَلْزَمْنَاهُ عَمَلَهُ. Allah has imposed the fate of every one of us, their actions. And the scholars who chose أَلْزَمْنَاهُ مَا قُدِّرَ لَهُ فِي الْأَزَلِ مِنْ عَمَلٍ وَشَقَاوَةٍ أَوْ سَعَادَةٍ is Ibn Jarir al-Tabari. Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, he took that opinion. رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ السَّمْعَانِ Ibn Atiyah. They took that opinion that أَلْزَمْنَاهُ طَائِرَهُ فِي عُنُقِهِ, it means يعني Allah imposed the fate for everybody, that which has been written فِي الْأَزَلِ مِنْ عَمَلٍ وَشَقَاوَةٍ أَوْ سَعَادَةٍ, that which has been written for each and every one of us, our fate, whether we're going to be from the people of Jannah, whether we're going to be from the people of the hellfire, how our actions are going to be. Ibn Jarir al-Tabari chose that opinion, and that's what it means. Ibn Atiyah also chose that, رحمه الله ورحمة واسعة. Some of the scholars, they took the opinion that it means ألزمناه عمله يجازى به وحده لا غيره, that the fate, so what was imposed on the person is their actions, in which they will be rewarded based on that. And from the scholars who chose that opinion is Ibn Kathir, Ibn Juzay, and others. They pushed that opinion. And there are some scholars who even combine between the first view and the second view, like Al-Biqa'i and Al-Alusi and others. Amin al-Shanqiti, rahimahullah, he says, في قوله جل وعلا في هذه الآية الكريمة وكل إنسان ألزمناه طائره في عنقه وجهان معروفان من التفسير. There are two well-known views, he says. أن المراد بالطائر العمل. Some scholars they said, الطائر, here it means actions. Okay, من قولهم, from the statements of the Arabs, طار له سهم إذا خرج له, أي ألزمناه ما طار له من عمله. The second view he said is أن المراد بالطائر, the طائر here is meant by ما سبق له في علم الله من شقاوة أو سعادة, that is referring to the fate that has been written and destined for each and every one of us, whether we be from the dwellers of the hellfire or paradise. Then Al-Allama Muhammad Al-Amin Al-Shanqiti, he said, وَالْقَوْلَانِ مُتَلَازِمَانِ, these two views necessitate one another. Because لِأَنَّ مَا يَطِيرُ لَهُ مِنَ الْعَمَلِ هُوَ سَبَبُ مَا يَؤُولُ إِلَيْهِ مِنَ الشَّقَوَةِ وَالسَّعَادَةِ, because the action that a person does is in essence what causes his fate to either be from the dwellers of Jannah or dwellers of the hellfire. رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ. And so, inshallah ta'ala, the two views, they are together. They are not two يعني, contradicting views, but rather they are two similar views, two complementing views that go together. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to judge us all, brothers and sisters, and account us towards our speech and our actions and everything that we say. And through that, we are either from the people of Jannah or we're from the people of the hellfire. And then Allah says, وَنُخْرِجُ لَهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَابَةِ كِتَابًا يَلْقَاهُ مَنْشُورًا وَنُخْرِجُ لَهُ, it means أي وَنُظْهِرُ لِكُلِّ إِنسَانٍ, it will be made clear to everybody, it will be shown to every individual. يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, the day of judgment, كِتَابَ عَمَلِهِ, the book of your action, you'll be shown it. And you will find it مَفْتُوحًا, open, lying in front of you. The book will be placed right in front of you, open. And it can, يعني حاوياً, it has in it لِكُلِّ مَا عَمِلَهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا مِنْ خَيْرٍ أَوْ شَرٍ, everything that you did in this world, whether it be good or whether it be bad, all of it will be there. So now you have to watch what you say. You also need to watch what you do, because you're going to be accounted for that. And that's in what Allah mentioned in Surah Al-Kahf, when Allah says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَوُضِعَ الْكِتَابُ فَتَرَى الْمُجْرِمِينَ مُشْفِقِينَ مِمَّا فِيهِ وَيَقُولُونَ يَا وَيْلَتَنَا مَا لِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ لَا يُغَادِرُ صَغِيرَةً وَلَا كَبِيرَةً إِلَّا أَحْصَاهَا وَوَجَدُوا مَا عَمِلُوا حَاضِرًا وَلَا يَظْلِمُ رَبُّكَ أَحَدًا. That day, وَوُضِعَ الْكِتَابُ, the playbook will be placed in front of you. فَتَرَى الْمُجْرِمِينَ, that day, the criminal, the wrongdoer, what would he do? He will look into his book and he will start to see things that he said and he did. And this is what he says, مَا لِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ, what book is this? What such a book is this that has in it everything I have said and everything that I've spoken? It has not left out anything. What type of book is this? You see? And the people will be judged based on that. Also Allah says in Surah Al-Inshiqaq, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِ فَسَوْفَ يُحَاسَبُ حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا وَيَنْقَلِبُ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِ مَسْرُورًا. The one whose book is given to him on the right hand, that person has been given a good accountability. He's going to enjoy himself and he's going to go back to his family. إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِ مَسْرُورًا, he's going to come back to his family happy, joyful. وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ, as for the one who's been given his book, وَرَاءَ ظَهْرِ, from behind, فَسَوْفَ يَدْعُو ثُبُورًا وَيَصْلَى سَعِيرًا, he's going to call on destruction for himself. He's going to what? He's going to call on to destruction for himself. I'm going to stop there, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaitan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdi, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.